Welcome back to the show. Before we left for break, we were talking about what you need to know about family, and we discovered that it is important to invest your time, to study, to seek for opportunities where you can learn more about family and successful marriages. We say you do not want to try family and fail. You do not want to try marriage and fail. You want to enter the institution of marriage. You want to start a family that you want to bring to the end. You want to go the long haul in your marriage. You want to stick to this man. You want to stick to this woman. You want to stick to your children to the end of it all. And we say we learn on how to do that. Those families that have stuck together to the end, they have had challenges, but because they committed, because they remained consistent, because they established what their vision was, because they had a mission, because they had values, then they were able to go to the end. Now, if you do not stick to your vision, then you are likely to fail. So we are saying, study to know how to stick. Study to know how to remain consistent. That's what we are saying. Let me say, when we come back, we will look at some of the challenges that bring separation in our marriage and institution. Number one, our greatest resource in our marriage institution is time. Time. We all have equal measure of time. But marriage as an institution, or family as an institution, the greatest investment of this institution is time. How much time are you spending with your partner? You know, if you're spending this much time, then you are investing this much investment in it. If you're spending this much time, then that's the investment you're putting in that marriage. So you need to put more time in your institution. Remember, above everything else, the most important thing in your life is God, in your list of priorities, and then number two is family. So the most important thing here we are talking about is family. So family gets the lion's share of your time in this life. So if you're not putting time enough in your marriage or in your family, then you're likely to fail. You're likely to become a stranger to your wife or to your husband. You're likely to become a stranger to your children. They do not know you. Why? Because you are not putting time. So you need to plan very well so that you have enough time with your partner, with your spouse. You need to have time with family, with your children, together, eating together, creating memories together, sharing meals together, reminding them of the vision, reminding them of the mission, reminding them of the core values, reminding them of who they are, reminding them of God's purpose for their lives. So time, you're spending time with your children. Unfortunately, many of us, because of the challenges of this life, we are not investing time in our marriage and family institution. And what happens? We fail because we become strangers to each other. You bring up children in your home, and when they grow up, they leave. They don't remember you because you never bonded with them. You never bonded with them. You never invested in time in your family. If you fail to do that, then I want to tell you, if you don't plan to spend time with your family, then you're already planning to fail in your marriage institution. And some will ask me, then how about feeding them, putting food on the table, ensuring that they are comfortable? Yes, that's your role. But again, your number one role is to ensure that you bring up fine adults, people of character. Your mission is not to bring well-fed children, well-educated but very useless in terms of character. You want to invest in their character. And for you to invest in your character, it calls for time. Time alone with mommy. Time alone with dad. Time alone with your children. Making sure that you know them, that they know you, that you have so much that you share together, that they can tell so much about you. You are not a stranger to them. It is only then that you are able to refine their characters, and they will become those people that you desire to see and to see grow up. You don't want to have a doctor in your house or a lawyer who is characterless, or who ends up becoming a drunkard or becoming a very dysfunctional human being because they lacked the emotional support that they get from their parents, either from their mom and from their dad. The best gift, we have said in this show previously, to your children is to love their mom, is to love their father, is to love your children. Love is only projected to these people by the amount of time you spend with them. So you tell me how much time you are spending with your family, then I will tell you how much you love them. You tell me how much time you are spending with your wife, then I will tell you how much you value her. You tell me how much time you are spending with your children, and that will tell us how much value they are to you. So we are also saying, number two is on how you manage your finances. So number one, you say that challenges in our institution of marriage and of family is time. And we have said we must plan to spend time and to invest more time with our families. So we must look for opportunities. And then number two, he said, is resources in terms of money. How do we spend the money that we have? How do we discuss matters of money, even within the family setting? These two are not to break families. You know, as a psychologist, I will tell you that many of my clients, when they come to me, their challenge is that they have become strangers to one another. So meaning, they are walking the road of separation. And when you probe or when you take them through a counseling session, you discover it is because they are not spending time with each other. And I can tell you, many will tell you, the reason why they break up is because I am no longer of value to you as I used to be when we got married. And that is only evident in the amount of time we spend with each other. Now, fathers sometimes will tell you that the reason why I'm not spending enough time with my family is because I am very busy putting food on the table, ensuring children go to school, and ensuring that my wife is well taken care of. You must do that. It is your duty, like you say. But you must also find time to ensure that you are supporting your family emotionally, that you are offering guidance, that you are offering counsel, that you are directing them on the path they need to go. They need to feel your warmth. They need to feel your presence. They need to feel your comfort. That can only be received by the amount of time you invest. And then number two, marriage breaker is finances. How are we communicating in terms of our finances? I have been to places where daddies don't know what mommies earn, or mommies don't know what daddies earn. And you know, sometimes when daddy doesn't know how much money earns, but you know that she has money, you are likely to keep asking from her, and you will not know when that kitty is depleted. Same with the father. When no one knows how much you have in your pocket, then they are likely to keep asking you. And this eventually translates into pressure amounting on these parties. Why? Because you have not told them how much you have. They do not know how much you earn, so they do not know the limits. They do not know at what point they need to stop asking because there is no more. But if we are open in our finances, if we can discuss our finances openly, then we get to walk the journey together. I know how much you earn, you know how much I earn, and you know that when we bring our resources together, then we have our priorities on what we want to do. When our money is put on the table, we are more happy, we bond more, we learn how to plan well together, and we know how to stick to our priorities, and we know how much goes into our savings together as a team. But when this is not done together, then it starts to bring division in the family, because then mommy has her money and daddy has his own money. When we divide our resources, then it means we are investing differently. We are pulling in two different directions. I'm not saying that a mother should not have her own money. No, she should have her own money. And daddy should also have his own money. We both have our own monies. But we are saying all the monies are pulled from the same kitty. Why? Because we are a family. We share in the same vision. We have a mission together, and we have our core values. If families can come together and discuss their money matters together, we would see more successful families. We would see more happy families. We would see trust continuing to build in these families. We see children who learn on how to manage resources, especially money, as they grow up. We see people who are not controlled by money, but people who are able to control money. People who do not work for money, but people who now are able to command their money to go working for them, while they remain happy because they have a vision which they share and they have a mission. So for this to be able to happen, then we must go to where we began. And that is where we say, number one, families therefore need to have a vision. We are only able to discuss our money matters as a family if we have the same vision. We are only able to put our money together on the table and have a discussion around it if we have the same mission. We are only able to achieve a lot on this line if we have the same values. But if we lack, if we do not have the same values, then we are likely to encounter challenges that will divide us, and eventually we will not be that family which we desire. I want to come to the end by saying this, that money is not as important as the marriage institution or the family institution. Nothing is important to us more than family itself. So it is not money. So money will not divide us. My job is not more important than my family. So my job will not draw me away from my family. And then number three, we are saying that family becomes number one in everything. So you need to also establish your priorities. You need to establish your priorities so that you know your priorities and you have them right. So that your priorities are not messed up, they are not mixed up. So you know your priority number one is God, Jehovah Elohim. Number two, your priority is your family. Number three, your priority is your work. So you need to have your priorities correct. When you have your priorities correct, then you are certainly going to be a happy person. Your family is going to enjoy having you around. Your family will be a successful family because your priorities are right. Your vision is correct. Your mission is well understood. Your core values are well in line. That way, you have laid a foundation for a happy family. It is my desire that this will be your passion, that this will be your desire to see a happy family, and that you will do everything possible that you are able to ensure that your family is very happy. Like always, I say, I am available to answer any of the questions that you may have. I'm also a trained counselor. I am very happy to offer family counseling. If you need me, call the numbers below, talk to me, write me an email, engage me on WhatsApp, on social media platform I'm available, and I am very happy to be of help to you. It is my hope that today was very educational for you as well as for me, and that the things that I have learned today, you have learned today, that would be able to enhance your relationship within the family setting and bring a satisfaction in this godly ordained family institution. Thank you for watching VBN. I look forward to seeing you again next week, same time, same place. God bless you. Keep it VBN.